Welcome to lecture 7 on mechanisms. In the previous parts, we have discussed about the quick return motion mechanisms, straight line motion mechanisms, intermittent mechanisms and the toggle mechanism. So today we will try to start with a new kind of mechanism known as the pantograph. So what exactly is a pantograph and what it does? Let us try to understand in this short lecture. Right. So this is what the pantograph is all about. The basic idea of using a pantograph is either to reduce or increase the scale of a shape or a configuration that I want to obtain. So now this is a pantograph that you are looking at, and this is a shape that is already available to me. I have a small heart shape that is already available to me, but on a smaller scale. Now I want the same shape on a bigger scale, right? So then what I do is, one of the links of the mechanism, right, is going to trace that small heart in the red color, right? So other point on the same mechanism will give me a scaled up version of the same small heart, right? So I am going to get a bigger heart. So it is nothing but a mechanism that I can use to either scale up or scale down the paths that are available to me. So that's exactly why we make use of a pantograph. Now let us go into see how the pantograph is constructed and how it is going to work, and let us prove that it is going to trace the path on a same, it is going to trace only the path that we are supposed to trace and nothing else, right? So this is how the construction of a pantograph looks like. It is nothing but a simple four bar linkage. So we have a parallelogram here, A, B, C and D. So it is a parallelogram such that AB will be equal to DC and DA will be equal to CB, right? And the link or the point CD are extended below to meet at point O, and point O is a fixed point, it cannot move. Similarly, point C and B are extended up to point E such that O, A and E, they lie on a same straight line, right? So that O, A, E, I am going to show that they are going to lie on a same straight line. So this is about the construction of a pantograph. As simple as that, there is a parallelogram ABCD, right? Such that AB and DC are equal, DA and CB are equal. CD is extended up to O, point O is fixed. CB is extended up to point E, such that O, A, E, they lie on a same straight line. Right. So now let me assume that the entire mechanism is moved down. Either it can move up or move down with respect to the fixed point O. Now let me assume that the entire mechanism has moved down below the reference point O, A and E. Now it has moved down such that D has taken a new position D dash, A has taken a new position A dash, C has taken a new position C dash, B has taken a new position B dash, and E has taken a new position E dash. Now what is that I am supposed to prove? I have to prove that the point E traces out the same path as described by the point A. I have a shape available at point A, so I am going to trace a path from A to A dash. I have to prove that E traces out the same path on a different scale. So as evident from the diagram, it is going to scale up the version that is available at A. But we have to prove that mathematically. But before proving, we have to remember one thing, that the entire mechanism is rigid in nature. As the mechanism moves, the dimensions of the link does not change. Even when it comes down, the dimensions remain the same, right? So it is a rigid mechanism. Let us keep that in mind before proceeding ahead. So we have taken the same configuration that was shown in the previous slide. So now I will take two triangles here. So the triangles O, A and D on the original position or the first position. I say that the triangle O, A, D and the triangle O, E, C are similar in nature such that the angle O, A, D and EOC will be equal to each other. So since the triangles are similar in nature, the ratios of the two triangles should be equal to each other. So let me take OD by OC, that is one ratio. OD is on a smaller triangle, OC is on a larger triangle. That ratio will be equal to OA by OE. OA is on a small triangle, OE is on a big triangle. right? That is EOC. Similarly, that ratio will be equal to DA by CE. All these ratios will be equal to each other. What are those ratios? OD by OC along this line, right? And again, OA by OE, that is along this line, and DA by CE, that is along this line. All the three ratios. So on the top, we observe that it is on a smaller triangle. On the bottom, it is for a bigger triangle, that is OEC. So those ratios will be equal and similar. So now let me say that I am going to come to the new position that is available at the bottom. Now let me say that the point O is fixed such that all A moves to A dash, B moves to B dash, etc. All the points have been moved. Now A dash, D dash will be similar to AD, because if AD was 20 centimeter in the original position, even when it comes down, A dash, D dash should be equal to 20 centimeter only. Just because that it has moved down, the dimensions are not going to change. The dimensions are the same, but it has just taken up a new position. Therefore, A dash, D dash will be equal to AD only, but AD will be equal to BC, and it will be equal to B dash, C dash. That is what we have shown here. What we are trying to say here is that as the mechanism moves to a new position, the dimensions of a mechanism does not change, they remain the same, right? So similarly, we say that A dash, B dash will be equal to AB only, they are not going to change, the dimensions or the length of the links are definitely not going to change. And similarly, right, so we say that CD will be equal to C dash, D dash. So earlier in the original position, ABCD was a parallelogram. Even after moving down, A dash, B dash, C dash and D dash is still a parallelogram, right? So we will continue. Now let us prove that. So if A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash is still a parallelogram, now let us prove that the triangles O, D dash, A dash and O, C dash, E dash are similar. So what are those triangles? So I have here O, D dash, A dash, which is a small triangle. O, right, C dash and E dash, which is nothing but a bigger triangle. Now let me take the ratios similar to what we have taken in the previous configuration, right? So now I say that, right, so the angles will be similar, right? So now let me take that O D dash by O C dash will be equal to OD by OC. It has to be the same, because just that it moves down, the dimensions of OD are not going to change. So OD by OC ratio should still be equal to OD dash by OC dash. The similar thing applies to DA by CE. So DA by CE should still be equal to D dash A dash by C dash E dash, because it is the same mechanism that has come down, not another mechanism. The dimensions and the length will still remain the same. So now that all the ratios are the same, the triangles O, D dash, A dash, O, C dash, E dash should still be a similar triangles, and thus we say that O, A dash, E dash will still be a straight line. So earlier also O, A and E were lying on a same straight line. Now again we have proved that even after coming down, O, A dash, E dash will still be on a straight line. So now from the previous equation, let me take that we have equation here. O, A by O, E will be equal to OD by OC and DA by CE. So now I have taken that OA by OE will be equal to OD by OC, right? Let me take OA by OE as it is, right? So OD by OC, that is OD by OC will be nothing but OD dash by OC dash. We already know that. Now what is OD dash by OC dash? OD dash by OC dash should be equal to OA dash by OD dash, because we have proved that the triangles are similar. We have proved that the triangle A dash OD dash, E dash OC dash are similar, and therefore OD dash by OC dash should be equal to OA dash by OE dash. Now we get the two ratios here. What are those ratios? Let us observe that carefully. We observe that OA by OE, it was on a previous configuration before moving, OA by OE, and we get a new ratio here, OA dash by OE dash. It is the configure, it is we say that OA dash E dash is still on a straight line, but it is after moving down. We say that both the ratios are same. So what does it indicate? It does indicate, or it does shows that as the mechanism is moved, the ratio of the distances A and E, right, from the fixed point O remains the same. It does not change. The distance of A from O, distance of E from O is not going to change. They remain the same, but it is just that the mechanism has just taken up a new position, right? So this will be true for all position. Whatever the position that you move, the distance of A and E from O is not going to change. So what we say that, so A has come to a new position A dash, E has come to a new position E dash, but whatever the path along which A dash has moved, E dash has also moved along the same path. But is it on a same scale? No, it is on a different scale, right? So O A by O E will be equal to 2. O A dash by O E dash will also be equal to 2. But the values may differ, right? Either it can be on an increased scale or it can be on a decreased scale. Now let us see the vice versa. Now that I have a shape available at A, so A dash was the shape available to me. So I moved the mechanism along A dash so that I obtained a new path, or I obtained a new configuration at E to E dash on an enlarged scale. Now let me say that I have a big heart available with me and I want to reduce the configuration. What is that I am supposed to do? At point E, I am going to trace the big heart. So what is that I am going to get at A dash? A reduced or a smaller heart on a reduced scale. That is what I am going to get. So if you trace along A dash, you are going to get an enlarged diagram at E dash. If you start tracing at E, right, E to E dash, if you trace, you get the same drawing on a reduced scale at A dash. So this is what the pantograph is all about, and this is how the construction of a pantograph looks like. You see that 30 centimeter, 30 centimeter, they are the same. 20 centimeter, 20 centimeter, they are the same. So these two are extended up to point O, which is fixed, and these two are extended up to point. So these lie on a same straight line. So I drag this point. This is the point which I am going to draw, drag, and this is the point where the pen is attached, so that I am going to get the whatever the profile that I am going to drag here. If I drag it along a circle of 20 centimeter diameter, I am going to get an enlarged one, maybe on a 40 centimeter diameter. That is what I am going to get at the blue end. We can observe a small animation that we observed here. So let me consider this as point A and let me consider this as point E. I have a small heart available with me. I'm going to trace the small heart. So point E is also going to give me a same heart on an increased scale. That is what the pantograph is all about. Right? Now let us take one more example here. Right? So this is a small cartoon that this person has. So as he tries to trace it, right? So now this is, he is tracing, this is the template that is available. So the template is a small template. I want to enlarge it. That is my requirement. Right? So now you are going to get the same cartoon on a enlarged scale. So that depends on how we are going to geometrically construct your pantograph so that it produces a certain scale. Each pantograph is capable of producing a certain scale. So that, based on that, you are supposed to design. So this is a flexible pantograph wherein you can change the dimensions of the parallelogram with the help of a hook. Right. So we have, this was the template and this is the reproduced one on a larger scale. So let me consider one more here. So this is the template available. So I am tracing the template such that the tool is also moving along the same direction. So this pantograph can also be made use in the machining operation. So this is the template that I want to cut. So I am just moving, right? So it is machining on a reduced scale. I am tracing on a larger drawing so that the pantograph is moving that table, machining table, such that I am going to get the same triangle on a smaller scale. So that is what the pantograph is all about. So this ends the lecture number 7. Thank you.